Cinderella.
Cinderella. It's freezing.
Poke the fire, Cinderella.
Really, Cinderella?
Cinderella, really?
Now, my daughters, I want to talk to you. Well, not you. I want to talk to my own daughters.
That girl always wants to sit down.
No wonder she never gets anything done.
Now, Joy.
Yes, ma'am.
And Portia.
Yes, ma'am.
As you well know, my little Muppets, this ball that the prince is giving is for one purpose only.
To choose a bride.
Exactly. And every girl in the kingdom wants to marry the prince, including you two.
Yes, ma'am.
On our shopping tour today, I bought you the most beautiful clothes with all the frills and frou-frou my purse could afford. So, whether or not you marry the prince, you'll both have to marry somebody this year.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, there's one thing you must remember. When you want to marry a man, you can't rely on your looks alone.
No, ma'am.
That does not mean, however, that I want you to neglect your appearances. Our family has always been known for its beautiful women. So now let's all go and get our beauty sleep. I'm exhausted from all that shopping.
I'm all tired out, too, going from store to store the way we did.
You're tired?
Yes, I'm tired.
I suppose you think you're the only one that's tired.
Well, who bought the most?
That has nothing to do with it.
That has everything to do with it.
Go to bed, both of you.
Yes, ma'am.
And you, don't sit there gaping at me. Make yourself useful.
Yes, stepmother. How can they be so tired? Looking at all those beautiful things and buying so many of them, I would be too excited to be tired. Oh, I love this room. When they've all gone out and there's nobody here but me.
I'm as mild and as meek as a mouse. When I hear a command, I obey. But I know of a spot in my house where no one can stand in my way. In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be.
Kind of sport, and yet it's fun. In the night I see fine father you are.
What do you mean a fine father you are?
I mean you never worry about him.
Why should I worry about him?
Because he isn't happy.
Oh, he's happy all right.
If he's happy, why doesn't he get married?
If he's happy, then why should he get married?
Look at your pants!
How could I have gained so much weight in just 5 years?
Because that's all you've done for 5 years. Gained weight! You haven't worn a court costume because we haven't given a ball for 5 years. The royal tailor will have to make you another suit.
But that costs money.
Wait until you see what this ball is gonna cost. Enter! Ah, the chef. Have you planned the menu for the ball?
Of the bare necessities for what?
For 1,700 guests.
That seems a lot. Don't have any king crab.
Very well, your majesties.
Hate to see that written on the menu. King crab. Seems like a comment on my disposition.
1,000 baby lobsters for the salad.
Wow.
And 500 pheasant for the pie.
Aye, aye.
1,000 pounds of caviar.
1,000?
Hush.
That's more than the sturgeon can supply.
I told the stewards to get us 40 hickers of lettuce and 600 suckling pigs for roasting.
What about the marshmallows?
Who wants marshmallows?
I do.
Why?
For roasting.
Show your knee inside a mouth and box of beef fillets.
Christopher, how are you doing today?
Fine, Father.
You're not unhappy, are you?
Why, no, Father.
Aha! Just what I thought.
It seems to me that you look a little tired.
I am tired when I think of that darn ball.
Oh, that. To tell you the truth, it isn't a night I'm looking forward to, dancing with all those candidates.
Candidates.
Every simpering girl in the kingdom. Every last one determined to show that she could be the perfect princess for me.
Well, we know how your mother feels about this affair, so it's best we not let her know how we feel.
I know. Mother!
Oh, hello, my dear.
We were just talking about the ball. It sounds wonderful.
Does it?
Yes. I was wondering if I could help with any of the preparations.
Well, yes, dear, maybe you can.
Well, I'll go see if the chef needs any help.
Getting a cold, my dearest? You need to take something for it. Won't want to have a red nose at the ball.
It'll be over by then.
Cinderella, my hat. My gloves, Cinderella.
Cinderella, my my flowers.
Oh, you all look so beautiful.
Yes, we do. Come along, girls.
Have a good time. Oh, I wish. Glad to see you. I didn't hear you come in.
I just knew I could find you in that same little chair, in the pale pink mist of a foolish dream.
Foolish? What's wrong with dreaming?
Fol-de-rol and fiddly-dee, fiddly-faddly-foodle, all the dreamers in the world are dizzy in the noodle.
But isn't every girl wishing and dreaming she were at the ball tonight?
And why aren't you there?
My stepmother. Well, somebody has to mind the house.
Do you know what I would do if I were you? I'd leave them. If you want to be a servant, you can go some other place and be paid.
You mean leave my stepfamily? Oh, I don't think if Father were alive, he would like that. Why don't you believe in wishes and dreams? That once in a while, something marvelous and magical can happen.
Well, I won't say that I don't believe that once in a while, something marvelous and magical can happen. Only thing is, it's dangerous to believe too much.
Why?
Well, you get in the habit of sitting back and expecting things. You've got to help yourself, you know?
I know. I always wind up just wishing and dreaming. I don't suppose that does any good at all.
Well, I won't say that it doesn't do any good at all. In fact, everything has to start with a wish.
Do you know what I was wishing tonight?
I'm almost afraid to hear.
I was wishing that pumpkin out in the yard would turn into a great big golden carriage that would take me to the ball.
What were you going to do for horses?
Four white mice would turn into horses.
Were you going to drive them yourself?
Oh no, there'd be a coachman and a footman too. Oh, I know what you're going to say. Fol-de-rol and fiddly-dee.
Oh, yes, fol-de-rol and fiddly-dee.
It's impossible, I suppose.
Impossible?
If only I had a guardian angel, or you, godmother, who are a fairy godmother.
Good joke. Very funny.
Just the same, I am wishing, in the name of every young girl who ever wanted to go to a dance and was told she couldn't, I'm wishing that by some magic or fol-de-rol and fiddle-dee-dee, that I could go to the ball tonight.
Impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a plain country bumpkin and a prince to join in marriage. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such fol-de-rol and fiddly-dee, of course, is impossible. But the world is full of zanies and fools who won't believe in sensible rules. Sensible people say, and because these daft and dewy-eyed dopes keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things are happening every day. Impossible.
Impossible?
Impossible.
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 Impossible. Godmother, that impossible things are happening every day?
Well, in a way, but
But the world is full of zanies and fools who don't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say. And because these daft and dewy-eyed dopes keep building up impossible hopes,
Things are happening every
afraid to go all by myself.
No, you needn't be. Except for one thing. Do not stay beyond 12 o'clock. See that you are in the coach and off for home before the clock strikes 12.
Why is it so important that I leave before 12?
No more questions. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Impossible.
Thank you.
our son's having a worse time than I am.
I've lost track of the prince.
He's dancing with joy.
Is he? Oh. That joy. I want a shot at him.
Your Highness, may I say something personal?
Yes.
I think. Very nice weather for this time of year.
You really should not be so personal.
But my mother told me to say something personal to you.
Perhaps you should return to your mother for further instruction.
I'm gonna be a lawyer someday, just like a namesake in Shakespeare's The Merchant of Venice. Her name was Portia too.
Really?
Yep. Someday, I'll stand up in the courtroom and say something about how, the quality of mercy is not strained. Know what I mean?
I'm afraid I do.
The party is beginning to look better.
I wonder who she is.
You know, watching our son dance with that beautiful creature really brings me back.
To where?
To when I first danced with you, my darling.
I wonder who she is. I never saw that girl before.
Well, whoever she is, it's clear he likes her the best.
Why have I never met you before?
Well, I don't get out much.
I have a strange feeling that something has just happened to me, but I don't know what it is.
That's exactly the way I feel.
Do you have any idea what it might be?
No.
Well, let's think back over our history together.
It isn't very long, is it?
10 minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling. You gave me the feeling. The world but no ceiling or floor. 10 minutes ago, I met you. And we murmured a how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found her. Of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the skies. In the arms of my love, I'm flying over mountain and meadow and glen. And I like it so well that for all I can tell, I may never come down again. I may never come down to earth again.
I have described my feelings, but you haven't described yours.
Well, they are very much the same as yours.
10 minutes ago, I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news. I have found him.
Over mountain and meadow and glen, and I like it so well.
Majesties, ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
Why would a fellow want a girl like her, a thrilling, fluffy beauty? Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a solid girl like me?
She's a frothy little bubble with a flimsy kind of charm, and with very little trouble, I could break her little arm.
Oh, oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her, so obviously unusual? Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a usual girl like me?
Her cheeks are a pretty shade of pink, but not any pinker than a rose's.
Her skin may be delicate and soft, but not any softer than a doze's.
Her neck is no whiter than a swan.
She's only as dainty as a daisy.
She's only as graceful as a bird.
So why is a fella going crazy? Oh, why would a fella want a girl like her? A girl who's merely lovely. Why can a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man? What's the matter with the man?
The ballroom is too crowded.
It's nicer out here.
Yes, it is.
I really must be going.
Why?
I promised my godmother.
Your godmother will forgive you if you're a little late.
Oh no, she won't. I have a strange kind of godmother.
You're a strange kind of girl. You haven't even told me your name yet.
It's a silly name. You wouldn't like it.
Of course I would. Whatever you are called is the most beautiful name in the world.
Midnight? No!
Please! Wait! Please!
Christopher! Are you out here?
I thought I heard someone scream.
Your Highness?
Christopher?
Christopher, what's going on? What's wrong?
I don't know. We were talking, and suddenly she ran away. I found this glass slipper on the steps. I know it belongs to her. Dad, we've just got to find her.
We will, son. We will.
May I send the herald through the kingdom in search of her?
Of course.
See that this slipper is tried on every young maiden in the kingdom. Every last one, no matter how unlikely she looks. Keep trying until you find the foot that fits the slipper. Do you understand?
Yes, Your Highness.
Find that girl!
Cinderella!
Sorry.
What a night. What a magnificent affair.
Were there many people there?
Oh, I should say about 5,000.
They must have a very large ballroom at the palace.
About a half mile long.
And what beautiful music for dancing.
Did any of you dance with the prince?
I danced about an hour with him.
An hour?
Didn't you?
Well, of course I did. If you did, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if the prince were to take one of my girls for his bride.
Did you know everyone there?
Nearly everyone. Except for some girl who arrived late and left early. Probably a princess or something.
Did she dance with the prince?
She was only there for a few minutes.
Did you go to sleep right after we left?
I was dreaming of what it must have been like to be at the ball.
You couldn't possibly imagine what it was like.
Maybe I have more imagination than you think.
When you're driving the moonlight on the highway, when you're driving through the moonlight to the dance, you are breathless with a wild anticipation of adventure and excitement and romance. Then at last you see the towers of the palace silhouetted on the sky above the park, and below them is a row of lighted windows like a lovely diamond necklace in the dark.
It looks that way,
the way you say.
She talks as if she knows.
I do not know these things.
Like a statue on the stair, you're afraid he'll hear the way your heart is beating, and you know you mustn't make the first advance. You're seriously thinking of retreating. Then you seem to hear him asking you to dance. A lovely night, a lovely night, a fine you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a charming prince, as charming as a prince will ever be. The stars in the hazy heaven tremble above you while he is whispering, "Darling, I love you." You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night.
A lovely night.
A lovely night.
A finer night you know you'll never see.
You meet your prince.
A charming prince.
As charming as a prince will ever be.
The stars in a hazy heaven tremble above you.
While he is whispering, "Darling, I love you."
You say goodbye, away you fly, but on your lips you keep a kiss. All your life you'll dream of this lovely, lovely night.
Worst nonsense I ever heard.
But mother.
Enough. Go to your rooms.
Yes, ma'am.
It's all Cinderella's fault.
Her trying to imagine what it was like at the ball.
It wasn't anything like that.
Nothing like it at all.
And you, clean this place up. It looks like a pig's pen.
Yes, stepmother. The stars in the hazy heaven, trembling above me, danced when he promised always to love me. The day came through, away I flew, but on my lips he left a kiss. All my life I'll dream of this lovely.
Let me try. You shrunk it. It fit me perfectly at the ball.
Is there anyone else in the house?
No. There is nobody else here.
And what about Cinderella?
Who's Cinderella?
She's just a sort of a chimney sweep and general helper here. There would be no use trying the slipper on her. She didn't even attend the ball.
I have instructions to try this slipper on everyone. I'll check the rest of the house, just to make certain there's no one else here.
How dare you come poking your nose into my business?
Your business? Well, I thought this was the prince's business. He is the one trying to find the missing girl after all, isn't he?
But, Cinderella?
Well, she's a girl.
Very well. There's no one else here.
What?
I mean, I told you so.
Well, I don't understand. Where could she be? Of course. I know.
You tried the slipper on every young maiden.
Every young maiden that could be found, Your Highness. I'm sorry.
Thank you. You may go. Who are you?
Oh, excuse me, Your Highness. I had no idea anyone else was here.
Have I met you before?
No, Your Highness.
Maybe it's the end of a dream. A dream that didn't come true, about a glass slipper that didn't fit anyone.
But Your Highness, you mustn't give up hope.
It was a wild goose chase. It was impossible.
But Your Highness, impossible things happen every day.
And even foolish dreams come true?
Why, yes, Your Highness. If you wish hard enough and believe in what you're wishing, even foolish dreams can come true.
Who are you?
I'm just a girl from the village. I think I'd better go. My stepmother will be wondering where I am.
Your stepmother will forgive you if you're a little late. Will forgive you if you're... Stop! Has anyone tried the slipper on you?
No, Your Highness.
I have found you, and I still don't know your name.
My name is Cinderella.
Cinderella, the most beautiful name in the world.